Hofstra University President Stuart Rabinowitz.
I want to thank Dr. Berliner, who was supposed to be retired, writing his, not retired, on sabbatical this year, writing the ultimate book on university finances. He did the call, which was a telephone call, but he served as dean of the School of Business, and he did a fabulous job, as I expected, and all this. But this is a wonderful event. I'm so happy to be here. Happy anniversary, Zarb, 50 years. You can see, sometime if you get the program and you're looking back, you'll see exactly the day it was started. I mean, Herman was 50 years older. And the only one who looks the same is Ralph Pauline. He looks exactly the same that he does on the Spanish. So I'm delighted to be here, and I'm here just to congratulate us all, and mainly to congratulate those who are in attendance, being the faculty of the Zarb School and the alumni of the Zarb School and the current students of the Zarb School. This school, School of Business, the Zarb School, has been absolutely central to Hofstra University's mission and identity since the university's very founding. We became a university in 1965, from a college to a university, I believe. And in 66, the Zarb School was started. And in 70, my home school was started, which was the most important. But over the years, as I said, the Zarb School has been absolutely critical to us. And it continues, and I want to, and really I need to emphasize that, that the future of the Zarb School is absolutely crucial to the future growth and success of the university as a whole. We are deeply grateful to the Zarb faculty who have contributed tremendously to the university's missions of educating students and engaging in developing scholarship. They have done what they were supposed to do. The Zarb alumni are among our most generous donors, and as importantly, if not more so, our most eager volunteers to come back and talk to our current student body and share the lessons they have learned, not only at Zarb, but afterwards. And they are successful, as you can tell from the members of this panel and others, in countless fields of business. And they have reputations for success, not just in the New York metro area, but around the world, around the country, and around the world. And I kept seeing Facebook pictures of Julio in Switzerland.
And I look exactly the same as I did back in 1971, right?
So what I want to say is the 50th anniversary of Zarb is meaningful, of course, to the business school, but it is meaningful to the entire university. I want to offer special thanks to the members of the exceptional panel that we will have the privilege of listening to. Each one of them is an incredibly successful and busy graduate of our Zarb School of Business. And they are taking the time out of incredibly busy schedules to help us celebrate to share their thoughts on what the next 50 years may bring. Each of them, and they will be introduced individually, so I won't do all of them. But each of them is a wonderful representative of this business school here. Their alma mater is incredibly proud of them. And they are, for our students who are here, stellar role models for each of you to emulate. And we're grateful, as I said before, that they can join us. Of course, we are also talking about alumni. Fortunate to have a school of business named after one of our very most successful alumni, and that is Frank Zarb. Frank was unable to attend this evening, but he's a long, and I'm saying this mainly to the students in the audience because everybody else, the faculty and the alumni, know Frank. But this school is named after somebody who's been a long-time trustee of the university and a friend, advisor to the leaders of this university for many years. More importantly, even more importantly than being advisor to the president of Hofstra, he has been an advisor to five United States presidential administrations. Presidents Nixon, Ford, Reagan, Bush, and Clinton have all called upon Frank Zarb for his wise counsel. He has also been called upon by the governor of New York for several leadership and task force assignments in the state and city. And he has an incredible record of business leadership and business success. And we are grateful that his name graces our wonderful school of business. So, and it is a wonderful school of business. And so what does it take for a school of business to be wonderful? Well, obviously, it has to wonderfully teach our students courses like finance and accounting and international business and so on. It must do that. But our business school also does more than just teach them the principles of these courses. It takes a step back and it teaches our students about the world in which businesses and they will operate. It helps prepare our students for a global, complex situation and a lifetime of opportunity. And it helps find jobs, but it does even more than that. It gives them something usually more lasting than the first job. And that is, it gives them the tools of a lifetime worth of learning so that they can adapt and succeed in the changing economy. And that's what the business school always has done, and that's what it will continue to be. It will continue to be a premier teaching institution in the United States for people who want to go into the world of business. But in addition to that, the school has done more, I think, beginning with our business development center 8 years ago, I think about 20 years ago that it started. The Zarb School has worked with and embraced the New York metropolitan business community. For example, today the Zarb School works with Capital One. Just some examples on such programs as Money in Me, which is a financial literacy program, as well as the Capital One Entrepreneurship Challenge. It works with Flushing Bank, which I think closed my first mortgage, actually, back in the day. So we hold with Flushing Bank a collaborative mentoring program, Ladder to Leadership, Nurturing the Next Generation of Women Business Leaders, which brings together members of the Zarb's Graduate Women Business Student Organization with young women in the Uniondale High School. Our sponsorship of Commerce Plaza ensures that thousands of fifth graders get an introduction to financial literacy and a business curriculum appropriate to their level of understanding through a field trip to that Commerce Plaza. Our students, through their organizations, I'm so proud of them, engage in many acts of community engagement, such as Vital. It sounds like a drink, but it's not. Vitamin Water. CFO for Vital. This is VITA, Voluntary Income Tax Assistance Program, in which students help local residents with their tax preparation. It is one of the largest university-run income tax assistance program in the country, and we have to get more people to understand it because it's a great service and it's great for our students. And our faculty MBA consulting group has for decades served the needs of startup entrepreneurs and also helped not-for-profits by consulting on their needs. And the Zarb School wants to make a difference in the community. The university wants to make a difference in the community. And it does. I promise that we will continue to innovate and we will continue to look forward, and there are some very exciting things that have just recently happened or on the horizon. So the Zarb School is a very important partner in a new center we have created at the university called the Center for Entrepreneurship. It is an interdisciplinary center and it's designed to encourage startup businesses and foster innovation among all of our students. And the Zarb School has played the leadership role in launching the center and encouraging innovation. We are also, do we announce this yet? But we're also beginning a new student-managed investment fund this year to provide students with the opportunity to trade in the markets and understand the real-life implications of their investments, so that students can be like me and every day look at the Dow and think about how much money the endowment has lost or the investment fund has lost, or gain, one or the other. So this will teach our students exactly how that feels. And we've just begun a fabulous new program through the efforts of Dr. Berliner with, and if I mispronounce it, I apologize, the Don Bai University of Finance and Economics, in which our undergraduate students have the opportunity to get a dual degree, a BBA from Hofstra University and a bachelor's degree from Don Bai, which, by the way, is in China. And after a course of study and an internship in China, they can get both degrees. There are few, if any, partnerships like this anyplace in the world. I think this program will provide a niche for the university and will forge incredibly strong relationships between our students and their colleagues in China and give our students unparalleled opportunities. And finally, next year, we'll recognize the needs and the importance of the Zarb School faculty and students by breaking ground finally on a brand new building to house the School of Business, one that will be worthy of exceptional programs and faculty here at Hofstra. So the new building will be not only adjacent to, but connected to CB Star, which is a classroom building for the School of Business. CB Star will be refreshed so that it looks compatible with the new building. And the total of the two buildings together will give our faculty new offices, provide more collaborative workspace, student lounge space, state-of-the-art classes. So our Zarb School has one central, large, integrated space to call home. So there are good things ahead to follow what has happened. So I am just, as I said, I'll close the way I began by saying I'm so happy to be here to celebrate 50 years. It's been a great 50 years, and it's going to be even a greater 50 years to come, and that's what our panel will talk about. And why don't we all promise each other that in 50 years, we'll all come back together again and celebrate the 100th anniversary. Thank you.